you could.
Sing and play guitar in Bloc Party.
Hello, I'm Matt and I play the drums.
I'm Gordon, I play bass.
What sort of play guitar?
But it's been forgotten. Again, I made you vow to pay you home. I really
sort of shy away from talking about the influences, and I've noticed that you guys don't do that at all. You're happy to talk about.
I thought we were quite shy about our influences.
I've seen you mention it several times.
Okay. Let's see. Usually because we're asked.
Go on.
I've got a whole list
of your
influences. But, are you shy about it, or do you, are you getting tired of certain comparisons?
Yeah, we
concerned of overrating it somewhat, but
I think hopefully people see beyond the hype, really, you know, and kind of appreciate us for what we are. We've all been there as music fans. Suddenly subjected to kind of, you know, bands are seemingly come from nowhere and then being really distrustful. So it's really, really strange to be on the other side of that.
I don't know.
Sometimes we get a bit irritated when people are lazy and stuff, and not, you know, haven't done their research or kind of resort to the same old questions. And I think on a personal level that makes me angry because I did want to be a journalist at one point. And it's not a particularly easy profession to get into. So it seems kind of wasteful for people, and people are just kind of sitting back and like cruising through their jobs in autopilot. That's my toughest stuff.
I'm going to put this on eBay. Yeah. This is the tape recorder that has written every song that Bloc Party that you've ever heard. This tape recorder is a piece of Bloc Party history.
I said that's the last one I just remember that, so. Oh, is that right?
Yeah.
Is this in the chorus, yeah?
Yeah, but I think it's...
It's rocket science.
Yeah. Now we're gonna return to form. We're gonna slam you. Ultimate party trap. This was Steve Aoki, standing over there. Buddy. I want to see some dancing from side to side.
She's walking around,
This next piece is a song about boredom.
It's a song really, I wasn't trying to, I was just trying to explain the way that, you know, a group, a generation are thinking right now about the future and about their aims and their ambitions. I think the word is ennui. I think that's the word. I was just taking a step back and looking at you know, our generation and seeing some things I didn't really like. So.
Yeah, I have a secret crush on Russell. Their album is just, they're just fucking monsters. They're huge. I drove from Las Vegas to see Bloc
Party.
Wow.
What are you doing in Vegas?
I'm a stripper right now, so I can fund my music career.
Right on.
My music career being going to concerts.
Probably price of gas. I can't remember the exact line, but it's when he's talking about George Bush and making the same mistakes about his dad and that kind of thing. It's just kind of.
What do you think of George Bush?
I don't know if he's a Bloc Party fan.
Have you seen Bloc Party before? How many times? Like.
I mean, as far as you're writing by what you're seeing.
Yeah, that song isn't about America. It isn't specifically about America.
Sure.
Turn that phone off. Only kidding.
Yeah.
That song isn't specifically about America. That song is about, you know, everyone thinks I'm talking about. I'm addressing George Bush in that song. I'm not. I'm talking about someone that I know personally, that, you know, isn't really concerned with the way that the world is working. You know, it's only concerned about junk food and the immediate world like around them.
We'll be right back. running on.
Hashish, yeah.
I bet he was working some hashish, yeah.
At the Merry Ward.
How long have you been playing music?
How long have I been playing music?
Yeah.
In terms of this band? Or
no, just on your own.
I've probably been playing guitar for about 8 years, I think.
And when did you immediately start writing music?
Yeah, because I couldn't, I was self-taught, so I only started, because I was a singer initially. I only started playing the guitar, so I was like being able to write stuff. So I didn't think I'd enjoy it as much as I do now. So.
What initially hooked for you? Was it like, was it just rock and roll, or was it blues influence? Like, was there like what initial like what your first song like? What was the major influence to the first song that like?
Well, there was all sorts of Motown playing in my house when I was. There was lots of reggae playing in my house when I was a child. My sister bought a copy of Heartbreak, which is a Blur album. She got it when she was like 15. I would always sneak up to her room and listen to it. So.
But the first tune that you wrote, like, do you know?
The first song that I wrote. Yeah, it was just something for acoustic guitar. It wasn't like that exciting.
Like, when did you know you were moving into like rock and roll, or what kind of?
Are there any straws here? Straws.
Straws here.
Are they right here? No, they're alright. So what did you ask? I don't know. I can't sort of think. If I'm thinking back to when I was writing my first songs, you know, I know now that they weren't very good, but at the time I was very excited about them. You know, I think it was just you need to make tentative steps when you're writing songs. You need to sort of find your own voice. You need to find your own style, but you only do that once. You'll only be able to do that once you've written lots of songs and you know what it is you like about stuff. It didn't really click for a long time. Too many musicians learn how to speak in a language that isn't their own when they learn, you know, lots of theory, and that itself can be really debilitating in terms of expression. So, you know, I was really, really adamant that had to know just the basics. You know, that kind of changed when I started playing with Russell. It's a banquet video.
They have a different vibe, different feeling, and a different sound.
Where's this next song? This next song is about ego and complacency. It requires some audience participation. Hit it. And the fee, what's the fee?
Free. Where are you? Hey, now for something a little lighter in tone.
Do you know, I was curious, was it kind of a conscious effort, or do you not, like, you sound British when you sing.
And really?
Yeah. It, like, it seemed for a long time that...
I sound British when I speak as well.
Disrespect, but I notice you stutter a little bit. Is that something that was hard to live with growing up?
Not really. no, not really.
Thank you very much.
It was a good show, actually. It's kind of felt like you're amongst friends, really. Best way. And we were, actually. There was a lot of friends of ours, like, by the side of the stage and taking photos down the front and dancing and stuff. So it was nice.
To be caught adrift, you've been trying to reach me, you brought me above. To be lost in a forest, to be caught adrift, I've been lost in a forest, to be caught adrift, you've been trying to reach me, you brought me above. To be lost in a forest, to be caught adrift, I've been
Thank you very much, LA.